She's a multi-talented performer, a best-selling author, and a true advocate for women's health. Her latest New York Times bestseller is called I'm Too Young for This. Please welcome Suzanne Somers. Ain't it fun?
Actually made me emotional, like I almost felt like crying.
Oh, well, right. That was because some, you know, people love you and are you?
I don't know. It's been so many years and you're still there and I'm still here.
And not only are you still here, I mean, we met at the, ages ago. We've known each other a long time and you don't age. You look beautiful. You look absolutely incredible. You look wonderful.
Thank you.
You know.
By the way, just a side note, I saw him at the Carousel Ball in Los Angeles last Saturday
night. For diabetes research.
You know, you should go into singing for
a
career.
Should I? Yeah. You think? Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Look, from you, I'll take it.
I'm trying to encourage you.
Yeah, really. You know, you got a future there, kid. Ooh.
Thank you, Suzanne. Thank you so much. Thank you. Well, duet partner, if you ever hear me.
Don't say that to me, because I'll...
You'll take me up on it?
You sing, right?
I do.
Start brushing up on your Dothraki.
Exactly.
Anyway. Duet album.
The Suzanne Somers, Josh Groban. Dothraki album. Yes.
I'm in.
People have been clamoring.
I'll do it for free.
Excellent.
Suzanne, I'm obsessed with you for many, many reasons. I find you very inspirational and very aspirational. One of the reasons I admire you most is that you've been married for 47 years. To the same man.
You know what's bizarre? He's my second marriage. I mean,
really?
Yeah. I was married at 17.
Well, we all get married at 10 on the
playground. Yeah, right.
I mean, that's
exactly.
Really, like, that's, I'm not including the lifesaver marriages. You know,
I was a Catholic schoolgirl and got pregnant as a teenager and got married and it was so wrong and I got a divorce at 19 and then I met Alan Hamill and that's kind of been my life.
That's the right.
So how do you do it? Like, everybody wants to know, how do you keep a marriage alive for 47 years?
Well, you fight for the first 10 years.
Yeah, right. Okay.
We were blending families. That's very, very difficult. Anybody here blending a family ever? It's just like there was no rule books the first time around. I think maybe now people understand you probably need to put everybody in therapy so everyone has a moment to express themselves, mm-hmm. but we're all tiptoeing around one another in the beginning.
Do you date nights, things like that?
So I write most of the day, and he's in his office making deals, and around the end of the day, a couple of times, he says more than a couple of times, but I don't want to sound like an alcoholic. So 2-3 times a week, he'll intercom me, and you want a date? And I go, yeah. And that means we meet at the bar.
Yeah.
And he pours me a stiff tequila.
Oh my gosh, what time does that happen?
Noon. And then what happens. Now it's the end of the day, and you know, we sit at the bar. I love bars. I'm Irish.
Yeah.
Irish either.
So naturally, the tequila.
Right. They have tequila all over Ireland.
All over Ireland.
Right.
Yes, the Irish tequila really is.
Irish either drink or write, and I do both.
So. Okay.
Right.
You're multitasking.
I'm multitasking. And so we sit at the bar. And I put on my favorite station, so this shows my age. I love Martini in the Morning. Do you know that station? You're
Martini
on it a lot.
I love that station. They've been very good to me, too. Yeah, it's great.
You and Barry Manilow, who's my dearest friend, and Diana Krall, and all my favorite singers are on Martini in the Morning. So we sit there with our tequila, and sometimes we dance, and we have these romantic evenings, and then...
And then you swipe the bar clean, and whatever happens, happens.
So, what happens?
Yeah. I love your ritual. We have to take a commercial break. But Suzanne's going to give us some advice on how you can live a more healthy, vibrant, vital life and increase your sex drive.
Good group. Thank you for the comment.
We are back with Suzanne Somers, author of the book, I'm Too too young for this. I'm such a reader of all of your books, and you are a tremendous advocate for women's health. Mm-hmm. And now this is your latest book called I'm Too Young for This. It's a natural hormone solution book to perimenopause.
Right. How to live a non-drug life and a new way to age. You know, if you look at the present paradigm of aging, it's not something that any of us look forward to, because it's usually sickness, Alzheimer's, heart disease, cancer, decrepit, frail, ending up in a nursing home. And many books ago, my life is in the books I write. This is my 25th book. I thought there's not one person sitting in a nursing home that ever thought they'd ever end up there. Mm-hmm. So what did they do? What did they do wrong? They didn't do anything wrong. Just out of ignorance or a lack of education, they didn't understand this new way to age. And so that's what I write about. Mm. If you do what I do, you'll never end up that way.
So what's the best advice you can give to women who are experiencing perimenopause?
Well, I call it the seven dwarves of perimenopause: itchy, bitchy, sleepy, sweaty, bloated, forgetful, and my favorite, all dried up.
Excuse me, I'll be right back.
So what you do is you take a blood test. This is not like guessing. You don't get anything over the counter or anything that's sold on a commercial. You get a blood test. You go to a qualified doctor. My book will tell you how to find a qualified doctor. Because if you go to a doctor who hasn't stepped out of the box to specialize in this kind of treatment, it's like going to a plumber for a heart bypass. With all due respect to all the doctors who are listening, they didn't learn it in medical school. They get about 4 hours of instruction in hormone prescription in medical school. I'm not a doctor, but I have spent hundreds, maybe thousands of hours writing these books. So, and then when you get your blood test back, you see where your deficiencies are, and it starts now real early because of toxins and stress. Around 30, 35 is not uncommon, and you notice the rise in cancer in younger and younger women, and you, with your doctor, put back in the form of rubbing on a hormone cream exactly your deficiencies. So what I need is different than what you need, what's different than Josh needs, and men need them too. And we women lose 90% of our hormones over a 2-year period. That's why it's so in our face. That's why you change rapidly. And I remember I had 3 years without hormones. I didn't know what it was. And I've always been upbeat and happy. And we've had this great sex life and just like passionate life together. And I didn't realize I'm snapping at Alan, which is not my nature. I don't snap at anybody. And Alan one day said, you know, a marriage can only take so much of this. And I thought, oh my God, I'm pushing away the person I love the most. So I got fixed up, and life is so great. And now, well, did I get there?